name of the Father, the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the sweet fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning to you all. At this Mass, we are requested to pray for and for Isabella Rocha and the family, that God may continue to bless and reward them. And for each and every one of you, their parents, their families, our school, God's blessings on our teachers and the authorities, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
My brothers and sisters, we are sinners and in need of God's grace. Let us therefore take a moment. Recall the times we have failed God and man. We have failed our friends. We have failed our parents. We have failed our children. Let us ask God for his pardon and peace.
Lord Jesus, you raised us to new life. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you forgive us our sins. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you feed us with your body and blood. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May the Almighty God have mercy on us. May he forgive us our sins and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. Be present to your family, O Lord, we pray, and graciously ensure those you have endowed with the grace of faith and eternal share in the resurrection of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Therefore, let us rejoice in him. He rules by his might forever. Let all the earth cry out to God with joy.
Because I came down from heaven not to do my own will, but the will of the one who sent me. And this is the will of the one who sent me, that I should not lose anything of what he gave me, but that I should raise it on the last day. For this is the will of my Father, that everyone who sees the Son and believes in him may have eternal life, and I shall raise him on the last day. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Did you guys notice what happened when you were singing the Hallelujah? Did you notice? You know, you were singing like angels in heaven. And I wanted to join. I couldn't because I'm on the bed. You are singing? Can somebody help me? Sing it again, let me see. I can't sing it. One, two, go.
Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah.
I wanted to join one. Hallelujah. Thank you very much, okay? You will all go to heaven, but not now. Not now, no, not now. Today, the word of God says, the acts of the apostles, the words of the apostles, what the apostles of Jesus did after his resurrection. Persecution came back to the church. As Jesus was persecuted, his disciples were persecuted too. Stephen was killed, the first martyr. He was killed for his faith because he told the people, look, you crucified the Christ of the Lord, but God has given you forgiveness. They were very angry that they were accused of the truth. So they killed him. Saul supported him. And today, we read, persecution came to the church. And all the disciples of Jesus were scattered. Everyone ran for his life and her life. They ran to different countries and different regions so that they can live and eat. But you see, in every circumstance, sweetheart, in anything that happens, God has a hand in it. Do you know? Do you know that when you are sleeping, God is awake, watching over you? You know? Do you see him sometimes? Oh, good. She sees him sometimes. Yes. So, sometimes when we are troubled, we don't need to bother ourselves too much. All we need to do is to do what? Bring ourselves together. Because when we are calm, we can reflect. We can think well. Sometimes we are mad with our people or with things. It doesn't produce anything positive. No. It helps to aggravate our anger and make the problem worse. But God knows what is happening at every time. And whatever that is happening for a purpose. And that purpose is for good. So, but if we do not take time to look at the situation well and to listen to the voice of the Spirit, we may not understand why what is happening is happening. God knew that he had prepared his apostles that they may go out to different regions and countries and spread the good news. And on their own, within their comfort zone, they wouldn't have been able to move. But persecution came. God already had given them the strength to withstand. So when the trouble came, they ran away for their lives. Do you understand? They zoomed off. Like those of you playing games, right? You speed. So they moved at a high speed to other places for safety. But they were moving with something precious. Who knows what that thing is? Who knows? Yes. God's love, yes, but there's something they were moving with. As they were running and running to other countries, there was something in them that could not be deterred or stopped by the persecution. And they were running away. Yes, honey. Faith, yes. Who knows? What again? What do you think the disciples were running away with? Yes. Yes. They were running with the love of God in their hearts. Yes. Yes, they were running with Jesus too, because they didn't leave Jesus behind. Yes. God's glory, yes. But above all, they had in them the power of the word of God. Did you get that? They had the power of the word of God. So as they ran away, I'm coming to you, honey. Relax, I will come to you. As they were running away, they had the word of God in their hearts, and they ran with the word of God. That when they got to Asia, when they got to all other places, they settled down. They felt that their lives were now secured. They began to preach what was in them, the love of God. They began to bring out from the store of their hearts the treasures they had in them, the treasure of the word of God. They began to do what? To bring them out and to share them with those around them. So for those who felt they were persecuting them, they had already heard the word. But God needed others to hear. And as such, when persecution broke out, the disciples and everyone ran away. When they ran away, they ran with the word of God. And when they settled, it's just like those of us that when we had a flood. You remember? When we had the hurricane, right? Many of us had our family, friends, our relatives moving over from Houston to Crosby to stay with us. Am I right? Many have people from Louisiana and other places coming. And many of them came with their stories. Many of them came with the wonderful things about Louisiana, about Houston, and about other places. And they told us stories. Am I right? So also did the disciples do. When they ran away, they ran to other places. They ran with the wonderful power of the resurrection. They ran with the wonderful gift of God's power. And when they settled down, they began to preach the good news. The good news of Christ's resurrection. The good news of God's forgiveness. The good news that we are restored. We have the hope of what? Of heaven. In our lives, sometimes we are over-worried about a whole lot of things. We don't take time to ask the Spirit, Lord, what are you teaching me from what I'm going through? What am I learning from what is happening? Where is the Spirit leading me? What is the purpose of this situation? That is what we should be asking ourselves at all times. For in everything we go through, the failures, the successes, and everything it is, the good, the bad, the ugly, With everyone we are going through, there is the hand of God in them for every purpose. The disciples did that. Remember what Jesus said in the gospel. No one the Father has given me will be lost. None. So, insofar as we carry the sign of the seal of the Lamb of God, we are sealed with the blood of the Lamb. We are shielded. We are covered. And as such, wherever we go to, and that is why in life on earth, we move about every day. But let us not forget that in our movements, that we carry the seal of the Lamb. We carry the seal of the crucified Christ. We carry the seal of the resurrected Christ. That when we move out of our homes, we are moving with the power of God. That when we go out, wherever we go to, we preach Christ. When we go to our classrooms, we preach love. We preach forgiveness. We don't preach retaliation. We don't preach hate. We don't preach curses, but we preach love. We preach blessings. Do you do that? When you leave your home and go to work, do you preach Christ? When you leave your home and you go to the school, do you preach Christ? When you leave your school and you go to the mall, do you preach Christ? When you leave your home and you go to the mall, do you preach Christ? Wherever you are, wherever God is sending you at any time, my younger ones, my brothers and sisters, God is sending you out for a purpose. God is sending you out that you may achieve. God is sending you out that you may be the Bible that another person may read. Somebody may not know that God is love. Am I right? But your love towards that person may bring the love of Christ to the person and bring some conviction and a sense of reorientation of an understanding. We pray today that we carry the word of God to wherever we go to. And let anyone, when we go home today, let us be the ones to remind our parents, Mom, Dad, we have not said night prayers. I want to go to sleep. Can we pray before I go to sleep? Do you understand? Do you understand?
Yes.
No, I don't want it like this. I want you to talk. Do you understand? Parents, it is the same with us, that when we go home, before our children go to bed, the onus lies on us to remind them to say thank you to the Lord that we went out and we came back. It remains for us to remind them that, look, many went out today as we all did, and they never got home. But we are home. Let us thank God for that blessing. Let us thank God and ask Him to protect our home, to protect the homes of others. Let us ask God to be with those who are sick, because we are aware that He may make them to be like us. We begin gradually to impart blessings, impart wonderful things on these children, the children that God has given us. Remember, the word of God said, children are a blessing from the Lord, the fruit of the womb. And they cannot actualize their blessings if we do not have them to enhance it. That is what our school is doing, to enhance the blessings. Then we should do what? Solidify it as parents, by good words, by good examples. May the Lord bless us and bless His words in our hearts through Christ our Lord. Amen. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. May we rise and bring our needs to our loving Father, who in His wisdom and love wants to hear us and come to our aid.
That in this Easter season, all who share a common baptism will find greater unity in their shared joy of Christ's resurrection. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for the world, that people of all nations will open their hearts to the victorious and risen Christ gift of peace. We especially pray for parts of the world that are being torn apart by violence. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for those who struggle to experience the joy of Easter in their lives, that God might remove all obstacles to their peace, freedom, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray for our Catholic schools everywhere, that the hope and joy of Easter might deepen the commitment of all involved in Catholic education to place their gift and talents at the service of Christ's gospel through our distinctive mission. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
Let us pray ourselves that in this Easter season we might find that we need to continue leading and serving with hope, peace, and joy. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For all those who have turned away from the church, may they have a conversion of heart and return to Jesus, who is the true bread of life. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
For the repose of all the souls in purgatory, and for all the special intentions we hold in our hearts. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayers.
O God, our Father, he said, let the little children come to me. Lord, we, your children, have approached your throne of grace, asking you in your mercy to come to our aid. Listen to our prayers. You know our needs. Grant us more than we ask you in vain. Through Christ our Lord. Sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and all this holy church.
Amen. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that we may always find delight in these pastoral mysteries, so that the renewal constantly at work within us may be the curse of our unending joy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, at all times to acclaim you, O Lord, but in this time above all, to laud you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. Through him, the children of light rise to eternal life, and the halls of the heavenly kingdom are thrown open to the faithful. For his death is our ransom from death, and in his rising, the life of all has risen. Therefore, overcome with pastoral joy, every land, every people exult in your praise, and even the heavenly powers with the angelic hosts sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Indeed, holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving you thanks, he broke it, gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. Once more giving thanks, he gave the chalice to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Daniel, our Archbishop, Chelsea's auxiliary, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and Saints, St. Paul, St. Peter, St. Stephen, St. Augustine, St. Elizabeth, St. Cecilia, St. Andy Bopre, St. Veronica, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, our Lord Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. How to call God Father. So with confidence we pray. Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, to say to your apostles, peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
May the joy and peace of our Lord Jesus Christ be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Now let us share time of peace with each other.
Behold Jesus Christ. Behold the love of the Father, the Lamb of God, who takes away the sins of the world. Happy are those of us called to this supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word and my soul shall be healed.
The body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ bring us to eternal life.
I
Let us pray. Hear, O Lord, our prayers, that this most holy exchange, by which you have redeemed us, may bring your help in this present life and ensure for us eternal gladness through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The seventh grade, right, will be receiving the traveling crucifix. Seventh grade, can you come forward? Into the hymn books and get a prayer for vocation. The first page. Open up. We shall say the prayer of vocation first. Then we shall crown it with prayers for our brothers and sisters who will have the traveling crucifix this week. Are we ready? God our Father, we thank you for calling men and women to serve in your Son's kingdom as priests, deacons, religious, and consecrated persons. Send your Holy Spirit to help us respond generously and courageously to your call. May our community of faith support vocations of sacrificial love in our youth. We ask this through our Lord Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Can I ask you something? What happens when the name Jesus is mentioned? Huh? I'm not hearing you.
Yeah.
You bow your head, right? Okay. Now what happens when Jesus is in your classroom? Huh? We bow our heads when we get there, right? And then we reverence God, right? We pray before it, right? And we don't make noise, okay? Knowing that Jesus is here watching over us. He's not there as a monitor to see who is making noise or who is not making noise, no. But he is there as a loving Father to support you, to grant you wisdom, to grant you understanding, to grant you love, to grant you patience, to grant you everything good. Am I right? Okay. So pray for our children, our brothers and sisters, that they, through the presence of the crucifix in their classroom, they may continue to gaze upon God and listen to God's words in their hearts. And through the blessings of the teachers, that they may become very wonderful people. Amen.
Amen.
May we all stretch our hands over them. Everybody, over them. Yes. Look at them, don't be looking at me. It's for them. Our help is in the name of the Lord who made heaven and earth. God Almighty Father, who bring your children before you. We ask you to bless them, sanctify them. As you hand them over the crucifix of our redemption, the sign of our salvation and eternal hope. May you continue to inspire them to greatness. May you continue to speak to them. Grant them a desire spirit, Lord, to listen to your words. Defend them from all harm. And may the love of Christ live in your hearts. Oh God, continue to bless their teachers. And as they enter their classrooms, may they remember that you are there. May they reverence you as your spirit prompts them to good works. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Amen.
I'll hand this over to you guys, okay? A lot of you will take it to your classroom. Remember that he was crucified for our salvation. Alright? So who will receive it on behalf of the class? Children, children, we have forgotten. Children, children. Children, children. No. Children, children. Say it again. Only one person has gotten something like that. Children, children. Say what you said. Say what you said, baby. No, I think she's the one. Who's children, children? Say something. Children, children, say something. Well, somebody said it here. Children, children. No, not yes, Father. Children, children. No. Somebody said something here. Eh? Yes, who? Say it again. Children, children. There's something you should respond. Children, children. So why are you keeping quiet? Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
I'm not going to teach them. You teach them. Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
They are doing the
friends of Jesus.
They are not hearing you. And because of that, we are going to repeat it 10 times. Yes. And I want you to echo it. That you may enter the hearts and ears of these younger ones. Are you with me?
Yes.
Huh? Are you with me?
Yes.
Good. Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
Raise the volume. Increase the volume. Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
Children, children. Children, children.
Friends of Jesus.
Children are the friends of Jesus. We are all God's children and we are his friends. Remember, Jesus said, let the little children come to me. Am I right?
Yes.
So every day, with a crucifix in our glass, let us walk closer to Jesus. Alright?
Yes.
The Lord be with you.
Amen.
May the Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Thanks be to God. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Do have a wonderful day, okay? Thank you.